Hello everyone. Today we will present topology optimization and redesign of the Avionic complement of the Spectre 3 rocket as the final project of the course. If we talk about the content of our presentation, after a short introduction, we will talk about why we choose this project and our motivation for choosing it. Then we will talk about our purpose of doing the project, the methodology, the result of the optimization we have made, and finally, we will finish with the conclusion. In model rockets, avionic parts such as electronic components, cameras, communication tools control the movement of the rocket during flight and provide information to the ground station. Our aim is to optimize the plate on which these parts are fixed as much as possible.
In this slide, we will present our motivation. The main goal of redesigning the avionics compartment for the Spectre 2 rocket is to simplify its assembly and lower production costs. By adopting new and cost-effective manufacturing techniques, we aim to improve not only the efficiency of assembly, but also the affordability of the build process. A significant focus of this project is to reduce the weight of the avionics compartment. Lighter weight allows the rocket to achieve higher altitudes, enhancing its overall performance and operational capabilities. Ultimately, the project seeks to integrate these innovations in a way that could be applied to other aerospace components in the future, promoting sustainability and economic efficiency across the industry.
Our project focuses on transforming the avionics component into a single-piece unit that is lightweight, durable, and compact. We employ additive manufacturing techniques to optimize the design, moving from the old to a newly requested configuration as illustrated in Figure 3 and Figure 4. Our approach starts by defining the design space and constraints, followed by using Fusion 360 for topology optimization. We further enhance our design process with MATLAB for additional topology optimization and Bezier surfaces generation. The outcomes include generation of STL and step files, comparisons, and comprehensive reporting by all team members.
Now I will continue with the MATLAB topology optimization process. First of all, I would like to explain our design space. We used the one third of the original volume of the avionics bay. The reason of that is to decrease the computation time. And in Figure 5, as you can see, the fixed nodes are given, which are the outer corners of the design space and the midsections outer corners. And forces are given from the outer surfaces of the design space. As you can see in Figure 5, 6, and 8, different volume fractions are used, and in table 1 the compliance values for these fraction values are given. As we expected, when we use more material, the volume fractions are decreased. Then we decided to use volume fraction of 0.25, because we wanted our avionics bay to be durable, but also to be lightweight as well. After we did the optimization process, to do the additive manufacturing process, we created Bezier surfaces in MATLAB. Then we created STL files in MATLAB again. Then we imported these files in Prusa Slicer, We use negative volumes for creating this design in figure 8. Then we exported 3MF file to do the additive manufacturing process.
Firstly, the dimensions of the avionic compartment were determined according to the size of the electronic components and the rocket. The dimensions of the created design space are given in figure 9. The slots and holes where the avionics cards will be mounted were determined. As a result of high accelerations during the rocket takeoff, high forces are generated in the electronic card holes. For these reasons, the forces were applied to the inner surface of the holes in minus Z axis. Forces are shown with blue arrows in figure 11. In order to create a more compact geometry and since the avionics area will be assembled to the rocket from the corners, fixed supports were given to 8 corners of the design space. Since the holes and the electronics cards will be located are very critical, no material discharge was made from these areas. Therefore, these areas were designated as preserve regions. Preserve regions can be seen in figure 11 in light green color. Then three different topology optimizations were performed to determine the appropriate target mass and mesh size. Table 2 shows the mesh size, target mass, mesh ratio values and material of the optimizations. Firstly, different target masses were compared. As it clearly seen in figure 12, more material is discharged when the target mass is 40 than when the target mass is 60. However, the integrity is still preserved. Considering the cabling of the avionics systems, the case with a target mass of 40 was preferred since both of integrity was preserved and there was more free space. After the target mass, the mesh size was compared. For the same target mass, first 4mm and then 2mm mesh was used for optimization. Surface quality is very important to prevent damage to avionic parts and cables. For these reasons, even though the solution time is longer, 2mm is preferred because it produces much better quality surfaces. The differences between the surface quality can be seen in figure 12. As a result, the target mass value was taken as 40 and the mesh size was determined as 2mm. As a result of topology optimization, the places where the material should and should not be discharged are determined. With this information, the solid geometry in figure 13 was created. The similarities in optimization 3 and figure 13 are clearly visible.
In conclusion, the plate in the avionics section of a rocket was redesigned to be lighter by using a design process. The process involved decreasing the planned weight from 60% to 40% and improving the mesh to 2mm, which made it easier to put together. These approaches demonstrated the power of using topology optimization in creating avionic parts and provide useful ideas for future design, aiming to save materials and keep strong structures. Since the 3D material reduction process could not be carried out in sufficient detail during the project process, this point will be examined in more details in the following processes. Topology optimization, which has been performed only for the avionics system, is planned to be performed for other structural internal parts. And thank you for your attention.